Alrighty, we're going to install a exit light. We're in a commercial building here. This is the downstairs rental unit, but we're just using it for storage. But since it's a commercial building, we're going to be putting an exit light over the door that goes to the back door exit. Here in the country I was born in, we use 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps, 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, the bare of the green is the ground. Red and blue are also live colors, however, you may find white live in a switch loop or a 220-240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral. So I'll show you how to install this. We're going to be putting wiring on the wall. We're going to be using what's called MC cable because Romex is not allowed to be exposed on the wall. You can also use wire mold or EMT conduit or PVC conduit. So we'll start with cutting our cable on both ends here. Careful not to cut into the conductors. Pop it back like this, break it off. Drop it back and forth a little bit like that. I'll bend this up so I don't cut into my wire spooling saw. And I'll take my side cutters here. And I'll cut off my sharp edge so I don't cut into the wire. And I'll do the same on our other end here. Again, careful not to cut into the wires. I have to go just a little bit more. Then we'll take our cutters here. We'll cut off our sharp edges here so we don't damage our wire. Okay, so now what we can do is we'll get our anti-short bushings and put our anti-short bushings on. Okay, these are the anti-short bushings to keep the next, what I'll do now is I'll put my anti-short bushing into my cable like this. Push it down in. Yeah, I get it. Seat it down in there nice and tight. And I'll take some electrical tape and I'll tape this bushing in place so it stays where we want it to stay. You don't have to tape it, but I like to tape it for extra security. Squeeze it down into place. Now I'll do the same on my other end here. Put my anti-short bushing in. Push it down in. So it's seated down all the way. So now we have our cable ready for installation, so we can clip off this plastic here. So we're going to come off of this box here because we have power coming to this box. Okay, what we have here is a switch loop with a neutral, and we did it with the neutral because we have a light switch on it, and we have an outlet, and we have to have a neutral for the outlet. Yeah, to get a couple of MC cable connectors. So I'm going to go in this one right here. Okay, so now we stick our cable into our box here. Thank you. rubber mount out. Make sure my cable's up in all the way here. There's the middle of our door. Get our box nice and straight. I'll get a nice clamp right here on the solid wood here. There we go. I'll come down and wire this box down here. Okay, so since this is a switch loop with a neutral, because we have an outlet here that's live all the time, we're going to hook our black wire to this one here. So we'll cut this right about in the middle here. With the size that matches the wire gauge we're using. This is 14. We're on a 15 amp circuit, so we're good with the 14, and we don't have 12. We only have 12 too, so we can go up on wire size for the circuit, but you can't go down. Okay, so we'll get these two together. We'll get our insulation even at the bottom here. Get them started. Bring our insulation over, get it in the middle, get the insulation even at the bottom here. Get a nice even twist like this here. Make sure all our insulation is even on the bottom. And we'll cut it so it's even with the shortest one. Here we are. Our three insulations are even on the bottom, and our three coppers are even on the top. And we'll put our red wire nut on here. There we go. So now we have our constant power going to the light. Now we got to get our white wire we're going to put on the neutral side of the outlet here. So it's out of the way of everything here. So we always loop our wires the direction our screw turns, like that. Close our loop the direction our screw turns here. Like that there, that's what we want right there. And now we got to get our ground hooked up here. So we'll take the one off of our switch here and we'll make a pigtail to go to the switch. Now I'll clip them so they're all even on the end here. Put my wire nut on here. And we'll put our ground tail up here on our light switch. Okay, so we got our wires hooked up. And now we're going to start putting our wires into our box here. Okay, now we can push our wires into our box, making sure that nothing is pinched. Get that ground wire over here away from everything. We don't hit any wires and put our screw in. Well, if I can't find my other screw, I'm not frustrated. I'm just going to go get another one. I frustrate over nothing at all. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Because it's not worth it. I'll finish it by hand so I don't strip my holes out. Get it centered on the bracket there. Push this ground wire back so it stays away from everything here. Back here, I'll just push it down, make sure it's away from everything. Make sure everything is all nice. Make sure screws don't hit anything. Wires are all good, so we can put our cover back on. Okay, now we're going to open up our hole in the back here to put our wires through. I just use a spade bit because it's a lot easier than trying to punch it out. So I just drill right in the center for the wires. There we go. That's our opening for the wires. Now I'll look up at my box. We're going to be opening this one. We're going to open this one, and you can see the line here, so I know it's dead center. So I'm going to make my wire hole, screw hole,
right where that line is. I want it to be nice and straight, so I'll get my hole right there. There's that one. Come up here and I'll get this one. Now flip it over and I'll just make sure I have a nice 8.32 hole. Okay, so since this is a metal box, we have to put our green bonding screw in the back of the box, and we have to ground our ground wire to the box. So we'll get our wires untwisted here. Make our loop the direction our screw turns. Try to squeeze it a little close, tighter. There it is. Make sure it's nice and tight, and we can fold our wire back into our box here. Okay, now we can take these screws out here. Okay, so I make sure this is right side up here before I put it on. We'll slide our wires through our hole. We have a little plug we have to plug in down here for the battery. So I'll take that. It goes in right here. Like that. And this goes up on our box like this. Thank you. nice and tight to our box. Okay, now we have our wires we have to hook up. Now, as you can see, you have 120 volt is your black, the red is for 277 volt, and the white is the neutral. So first we'll hook our white wire up to the neutral. Strip it the same length. Okay, so we'll get our pre-tinned solid wire, our tinned stranded wire lined up even, insulation even at the bottom, copper even at the top. Put our wire nut on, make sure the insulation goes up into the bottom of the wire nut. Make sure it's nice and snug and our insulation is up inside, so we can fold this back out of our way here. We'll do the same with our black wire. Insulation even at the bottom and our copper even at the top like this here. Take our wire nut, make sure it's grabbing both of them. Make sure insulation is going up into the bottom of the wire nut. And we'll fold it in so it's out of our way. Now this wire we're not going to be using because it's for 277 volts. I'm going to fold the end over here like this so I can put the wire nut on it. Because we don't want to touch anything we don't want to touch, so we'll stick our wire nut on here. Well, it doesn't want to grab, so I'll just do it again. If it doesn't go right the first time, you just do it a second time. There we go. Squeeze them a little bit tighter. See how I have it folded over and pinched down real tight? Okay. Nice and snug now. So we'll get our wires into our tracking up here. Make sure our wires aren't going to be pinched when we put our cover on. Okay, all our wires are back on the way here. I gotta push them. Get them under that little clip there. Everything is all where I want them. That's nothing being pinched here. Nothing's pinched here. The wires are all out of the way of everything. So now we're ready to put our cover on. Alrighty, so now our light comes with the red and the green inserts. You can just pull the red one out and snap the green one in, but we're using the red one, so I'll just snap this on up here like this. Okay, snapped in. If the wires are pinched anywhere. Okay, we'll get a couple more clamps on here. See what we got one. Here. Here to keep it straight up this way. Okay, we'll go turn the breaker back on here. You can pause the video to read the information. Alrighty, so thanks for watching. That is how to install a exit light in a commercial facility here. It's we're in a very nice luxury apartment complex. There's like 9 luxury apartments upstairs, and there is this downstairs unit, which isn't being rented yet, but it will be in the future. I enjoy working for this landlord. He has a very good reputation around town, and it's a pleasure to do some electrical stuff for him and make some videos. Peace. Thanks for watching.